The blood that washed my sins away.
This is a story of long ago, of a man who owned a little store. And I was mighty proud to have my name up over the door. This was some 2,000 years ago, as I recall. Located in Jerusalem, across the street from Palace Hall. I had everything I thought I'd ever need. And folks who come for miles around, regardless of their creed. The only thing I had I didn't think I could ever sell was in a corner on a shelf, three old rusty spike nails. And then one day, a big Roman soldier came through the door. As he walked up to me, it seemed he shook the floor. "Can I help you, sir?" I said with a voice I guess seemed frail. He looked at me with a sneering grin. Said, "I want to buy some big, big nails. Three old rusty spikes is all I have, sir." He said, "For me, that'll do. For the job I have, three's enough. Now, how much do I owe you?" He placed some money in my hand, and I was glad to make the sale. Then I wondered, and I asked him. I said, "Sir, what can you do with just three nails?" He said, "Did you ever hear of a man called Jesus the Nazarene?" "You mean the one who goes about doing good?" He said, "Yes, that's the man." He said, "Well, today I intend to show the world that I'm boss. For with these three old rusty spikes, I'm going to nail Jesus to the cross." I stood there almost numb. You'll never know how I felt. I said, "Please, sir, don't do that." As down on my knees, I knelt. He just turned and walked away. I got up and followed him. I said, "Please, sir, I'll buy them back." But he just looked at me and grinned. But across the distance, I could see the howling mob through the tears that filled my eyes. "Away with him, crucify him." I could hear their angry cries. And over all the groans and the pains of agony, I could hear the sound of a hammer as that big Roman soldier nailed Jesus to a tree.
With three rusty nails, they nailed Jesus to the tree. The sun turned to darkness on that day. Was the day that Jesus died, and the blood flowed from his side, the blood that washed my sins.